We are getting close to Valentine's Day. So I thought I would create a look for you, but I kind of want to go over some of the basics. I've had a lot of you ask about highlights. Sorry, I'm trying not to swallow really loud. And also it's really echoey in this room, so I hope that this doesn't sound terrible. I wanted to try this new primer, so that's why it's right here. Anyhow, a lot of people have asked about getting dewy and glowy skin without drinking 1,000 gallons of water and running 5 miles a day. So I am here to help you fake it today. I always start my skin with Urban Decay's Vitamin Infused Complexion Prep Spray. Say that 5 times fast. Everybody knows that I always use this Primetime Bare Minerals, and it's the brightening. I really swear by this stuff. It's wonderful. But today I am going to try Benefits Professional. Now that I have cleaned my face. Ooh, that feels really good. Mmm. It smells really good too. It's really soft. It smells really good. I feel like I might need a little bit more. I feel like maybe I didn't get enough. But since this is the first time I'm using it, I can't tell. So I'll be kind of doing a product review on some things as well because I haven't used them before. So this is kind of like a chat and play, but ultimately I plan to use the Urban Decay Naked 3 palette, the NARS in Custard. And just check that on anywhere that you need a little extra coverage or a little color correcting. I always use lip balm, and I've already used my Rosebud Salve on my lips, so they are nice and pretty, especially since we're using a red. We do not want to have any type of chapped situation because that red clings to it and it'll get cakey and just gross and very unappealing. I'm gonna put a little bit more here. My skin is really uber red today, so I also thought that today would be a really good time to show you exactly how good some of these cosmetics can make your skin look and how you can really fake a glow, because already just between the Benefit and the NARS, my skin's already looking less angry. I wonder if my camera placement's good. I feel like I should. Let's try this. Oh, I am so clumsy, you guys, and I'm really sorry that I'm so clumsy. There, that's a little better, do you think? Let's try that. I have been liking to play with this a lot lately. This is, and I'm gonna pull up both ends. This is NYX Wonder Stick. And NYX actually has some great, they have a really great line, and they have a lot of really good dupes. So if you like something from Too Faced line or something from a higher end, check NYX out, and it's both a bronzer and a highlighter in one. So we're just gonna kind of play around with this a little bit. I've been messing around with it some, but I haven't got it mastered. So this is what I'm gonna do today. And I also have a little beauty blender too that we're gonna use with this. And I am going to, I want this to be a, since we're gonna use such a bold lip and such a clean eye, I want this to be a really bright look. And also, I am exhausted. Like, I am not even kidding you. I am so tired. My daughter got her tonsils and adenoids out, and I have 2 other children, and it has been a, we've had some pretty terrible nights, I'm not gonna lie. So, this baggage, the skin, not good. All right, let's see if we can fake this out. And I'm just gonna do like an upside down triangle, and I'm bringing it down, you can see quite far, cause like here's the apples of my cheeks, so I'm bringing it down like really far on this highlight end. And let's do another upside down triangle right here, because just why not? I am going to just go right along the top. Here's the bottom of my jawline. I'm gonna go along the top. I'm gonna go down the middle of my nose, a little bit heavy on the tip. I'm gonna do my Cupid's bow with this. And you can just plop this on anywhere. And I'm gonna go right above my cheekbone right here. Awesome. And you know what? Let's just go below too, because why not? This is light medium is the shade that I'm using. And I'm gonna frame my face like I would do with a powdered bronzer. So I'm gonna just do like a few lines over here. I'm gonna kind of dot it along here. Just a dab on there. And I'm gonna go right where I would put my bronzer, right here. And again, we're not going all the way down. We're just gonna do right here, same here. And we're gonna go right along the sides up into our brow bone. Oops. And we're gonna go down a little. And I'm gonna go down a little bit on my nose underneath that highlight there. It looks like I'm going into battle, don't I? I'm gonna win. The flat end of my beauty blender. And I'm just kind of pressing it into my skin. All right, now we're gonna take this end, the sharp end, and I'm gonna use that for my contour, my cream contour. And I am dragging it back into my hairline, as you can see. Oh, I forgot to go along my jawline. What a ding dong. I'm gonna start below my earlobe, and I'm gonna go all up here, and I'm gonna do a little bit of a V. You guys know that trick. I'm gonna go all the way back up to my earlobe. You want this to be nice and blended on the underside so people don't think that you just did a shitty job with your foundation. There we go. Now we're gonna go up along our nose here, and I'm gonna add a little bit more highlighter right there, because I feel like it just kind of got overlapped. It's so good. It's a sculpting highlight chubby stick. So I have not used this yet, but I'm gonna give it a go. Wait, maybe I did use it. I think I did use it in one of my tutorials and I did not like it. Let's try it again. I need to look back at my videos and see if I've done a plum or a brown. I am loving that the 90s stuff's coming back, like the chokers and all of that. I am really obsessed with it. I do not like that this highlighter, because I want something that's really aggressive, and this is just not doing it. So I'm gonna go to my, where's my Copacabana? Cause I love it so much. My Shiseido foundation brush. Oh yeah. So we're really, really working on our highlight today. My allergies are going bananas. My Bare Minerals Original, and this is in, I'm gonna go in the medium beige. I have a lighter color that I might have to switch to because I don't have a fake tan or anything on. So I might have to switch to that. But for now, since this is gonna be a nighttime look for our romantic Valentine's date. And I dab this on. And we are just gonna put this all over the top to kind of smooth everything out. Oh, I really need a headband. All my little bitty baby hairs keep getting in my face. I wish there was one around here. Sorry about that extreme close-up. It was very Wayne's World. My IT contour brush that I got at Ulta. My NYX Matte Bronzer in Medium 03. I believe it's 03. No. Yeah, 03. I'm just going to press that in. See how that looks? We're totally not leaving it like that. Blend it out. Don't go below this line when you blend. We're gonna frame our face. Make sure you get right in that hairline so there's no, so it's seamless. We're gonna drag it back just a little bit. That's our secret to not look like we have a double chin. We're gonna shade it in. And we're gonna do our V. All right, we're gonna go right here again, drag it up into the brow. Right here on the tip of our nose. This is a bomb ass contour, ladies and gents. I feel like this camera's not picking up how effing pretty it is. See how pretty that is? See if I can get my camera back down. I shouldn't have taken it off. My tried and true Becca. I love this one. And this is just the original. Oh my God. And if you've seen my videos, you know I do like a little C motion. This is so pretty. Every time I put this highlighter on, I swear, it's like, oh, I feel like it's the first time I'm using it. Give it the Tin Man. Cupid's bow. And with my Too Faced, my Candy Glow. This is the Sweethearts, which is very appropriate considering it's gonna be Valentine's Day soon. Get those apples. And right above your contour, you're going to blend the bottom part of your blush in with the top of your contour. I really like the Urban Decay, and it's the original. I swear by this stuff as far as eyeshadow primer goes. Actually, let me do my eyebrows first. I don't know why I always do this. I'm always like, oh, I'm gonna do my primer. Oh, just kidding, I don't know why. It's like I become completely moronic whenever I turn this on. Buck. From the Naked Original palette. It's a matte brown. And I'll just use that. I don't have my eyebrow comb. It's not as good as the angled brush, but it's better than nothing. I am gonna do my arches a little bit higher than I normally would, just because I want this to be, since our eyes are gonna be a little more neutral, then our brows will be a little more of a focal point than normally. And don't forget, you want see how the front is a little more sparse than the rest of it, and that makes it look more natural. Nobody wants an even like Sharpie line. Nope, do not do that. Unless you want to, and then do it. And then we'll all make fun of you for doing it. I'm just kidding, we won't. My eyebrows are so sparse. I feel like I can't throw any eyebrow shade with mine looking like they do. So I joke around a lot so nobody get like super defensive and like start clicking like mean comments. Well, I don't know, you guys probably all watch it on your cell phone, so don't be all like. I use it on my laptop, and it's so weird whenever I use it because I feel like I'm like sleeping in my high school bed or something. It feels so weird whenever I finally use my computer for something. Once again, Urban Decay Naked One palette saves the day. We are going to prime our eyes. Sorry, I keep getting these little fuzzies. And it's not a mustache. Please let it not be a mustache. All right, we're gonna prime our eye, our tear duct, and right underneath. And again, I like to use my ring finger because I feel like it's not gonna do a lot of damage to our delicate eye skin. And also, I'll tell you guys a little tip. because I think that we can all use tips and learn from each other. I always use Clear Eyes or Visine before I start my makeup because I, by the end of doing my makeup, my eyes are sometimes really, really red. So I always start off with with two drops of Clear Eyes or Visine in each eye, and I always carry some in my purse, just like my lip balm, and I always carry some in my makeup bag. We are going to use the Naked 3 palette. A lot of you guys have had questions about these, and I don't think I've done a look with this one yet. So I thought, since it's really actually kind of soft, it comes with a really pretty dual-ended brush. I am really clumsy, and I am so sorry, but I leave a lot of my bloopers in because why not? I'm not perfect. And so it comes with this really pretty dual-ended brush where one side's a little bit more flat and the other side is a little more fluffy. And here is what the palette looks like. See how pretty that is. But it's, whenever, it was one of my first videos and I did a look on the Urban Decay Original. And it being my favorite, and I told you it's because there was a range of, a wide range of colors. This is one of the, one particularly, I was pointing the finger at this guy. Nothing wrong with it. It's a beautiful palette, but, if you'll look, see, it's just got like tons and tons of pinks and purples, and then it just has like a black, a gray, and then a couple of kind of like shimmery brown kind of colors, and they're pretty, don't get me wrong, but it's just primarily the same, you know, color scheme. And I don't know, I like, here, let me pull up the, is the original Naked, see? And it is really abused. I need a new one so badly. And I'm also afraid they're going to discontinue it because this is my all-time favorite palette. And see how they have pinks, browns, bronze, some more, some like dusty pinks and dusty purples. Great. See, it's more of a range of shades. And I'll put the other one up next to it. Ah, come here, little fella. Sorry, I dropped it because once again, I'm clumsy as fuck. There they are next to each other. See the difference? And obviously I use this one way more because this one is a little softer and I just really like bold looks. And this is beautiful on light eyes. The original's beautiful. If you have green or blue eyes, oh man, or hazel eyes, it's so pretty. So I have no idea what I'm gonna do. I am realizing just like in all of my other ones, I probably should have thought this out, but I know I'm gonna stick with something like light and neutral. So I'm gonna take this fluffy brush by, this is an airbrush shadow brush by It Limit. It's this really pretty matte color. And I am gonna go right in the crease with that color. And when you're working with the lighter colors, it doesn't need as much blending because, obviously because they're light. I am actually gonna pull that color down here with that, and I'm just gonna use the same brush, and I just am gonna pop a little bit of it on. So it's not super bare. Pretty. Oh, look at this. Guys, I'm so sleep deprived. I'm sorry that my skin looks so bad and I'm just, but this is good. This is good that it looks bad because now you guys can see what we can do. And if I wasn't like chit-chatting the whole time, this would, I probably would have been done. But I'm in no rush. I don't know. Hang on, let me swatch these because I know I want to use one of these. I just don't know which one. Ooh, you know what? Let's do a halo. Let's do a little bit of a halo look. Okay, a halo is where the out corner and the inner corner are the same color, usually darker, and then the middle is a different color, and it's usually lighter. I'm gonna just use the flat side of the brush that was in the compact. I'm gonna use the flat side, and I'm going to take a trick. It's this one. Side. And the inside, right there. So basically the outer third and the inner third of your eyelid. This is not a dark palette. Okay, we're gonna just use that same brush and I'm just gonna take a tissue and I'm just gonna kind of wipe it off, wipe that extra shadow that we just used off. Make sure it's off good. Dust. And it's this real pretty, it's the second shade, and it's a really pretty pink, and it's really pale, and it doesn't look like it's got a whole lot of pigment to it, but that's okay, because we're going to use that right in the center. Okay, there we go. And we're going to overlap it onto a trick that we used. We're just pressing that in. I don't see. If I see fallout, I'll just kind of like blow because I'm trashy. I know that some of you have all these fancy things and I don't know, I just blow it off or I'll like sweep it off with a fluffy brush whenever I'm done. That's really pretty. But super, super, see how basic that is. And I'm gonna take that same brush and wipe it off again. And I'm gonna go back in with Trick because I feel like this could just be deepened up just this tiniest bit and just kind of blended in to the dust color that's in the center. We're gonna take Trick and we're gonna put it right on the end of that same flat brush and we are just gonna bring it down and run it along our lower lash line. And that's all I'm gonna do with this look since we are gonna do a bold red lip. And take my MAC curler, curl the lashes. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do a little bit of liner. See how I'm all over the place? Unscripted. It's had to be. Okay. I'm gonna take this little mirror right here because it's the closest thing I have. And I'm going to just, I'm not gonna make it really big. Well, I don't intend on doing it. Sometimes I like have a mascara up and then I end up having to do like this really dramatic wing. But I'm gonna do the slightest wing and I have plan on bringing it really, really close to the lash line. But I usually don't curl my lashes first either. See, it's getting like all over my lashes. And see, this is just a baby wing, just really, really slight. So that way, whenever you look down, it just kind of goes up just a little bit. Aye! And guys, please do your liner before you curl your lashes because usually mine fall down in 5 seconds, but the one day that they're like deciding to stay up, Strange is the lightest shade in the palette, and I am gonna put just a little bit. I've wiped off my flat brush, and I'm gonna put a little bit on there and just right in tear duct there. I'm gonna take that same color, and I'm just gonna go right along my brow bone, but just really light. We are going to curl lashes again. I think our liner's dry. We can always go back in and clean it up if it's not. My MAC Upward Lash in Upward Black. This is supposed to be a curling formula and a curling brush that really helps to lift the lash. I'm gonna go in with this color right here, next to the last, and it is Dark Side. And I am going to take a liner brush from ELF, and I'm gonna get a little bit of that color on here, and I'm just gonna kind of press it up against my lash line. And then I'm gonna I'm not really gonna smoke it. I just want a little bit under there. See that? It's not a lot, just a little bit. And it's just gonna widen our eyes just the slightest amount. And I have such fine lashes just in general, but also particularly on my bottom lash that I need to darken the background just a little bit so you can't see exactly how sparse they are. It helps to kind of fill it in. And just gradually build it up. And this is like a crazy wearable daytime look for this palette too. This palette it's very daytime appropriate. Tarte liner. And I really like this one a lot. And it's just an inner rim liner. And it, oh shit. I just broke a chunk off. Never fails, man. Oh well. Right there on my waterline. And this just brightens it up. And if you have any red there, it covers it right up. It's amazing. I love this stuff. And the difference between that and this. It looks so pretty. See that? I see you. This is Clinique. They have a lower lash mascara and it's just in black. And look at that little brush. So little. Lower lash mascara by Clinique, and I'm gonna do my lower lashes and I can totally do that off camera. I have another tip too. Whenever we're putting on our mascara, a lot of times we will accidentally get it on our face somewhere, but we've already done our makeup. Leave it there, go back after it's dried off, and you can literally just like flick it right off. So we're gonna do that. NYX Rose Dust, is that what it is? Oh no, this is Soft Pink, sorry. How did I get that? And I'm just gonna use a nude color because I forgot my red liner. I cannot believe I did that. And see, you could do a lip like this with a little gloss, walk out the door. But we are gonna glam this up a little bit. I think this might be ready. Oh, it was not ready, so all I did was smudge it. Do not do what I did. I thought it was ready. All right, see? Dry. It just came right off. Look at that. Boom. All right. I'm going to apply some false lashes. And I'm going to do this on camera because I always fuck this up somehow. Maybe this time will be different. And I am using just the Salon Perfect in 21. I really like these lashes. They're really an all-purpose. And I trim them up from the outside. Throw some glue on this bitch. I'm gonna go ahead and put glue on both of them. So that way by the time I've finished applying the first one, then the second one will be ready. And as usual, I put a little extra on the, right here on both ends because those tend to come off a little faster. And I have discovered NYX Liquid Suede, and you guys have seen me use these in a lot of my tutorials. These are wonderful. This is shade 11, and this is the prettiest red I've ever used. But your lips need to be moisturized. I cannot stress that enough. So, I thought I saw something, but it was nothing. All right, I'm gonna go in with this. And it dries really, really matte. So it looks like a lip gloss whenever you put it on, but it's insanely matte. And I'm gonna blot and reapply. This is probably my favorite red ever. It's not too dark, it's not too bright, it's really pretty. And then we're just gonna blot the middle so it doesn't get all over our teeth. And then I am just gonna take some Brilliant Color from Ulta in shade 60. I just have a bunch of these kind of translucent glosses laying around, and you can see it's already really matte. See that? It dries in 5 seconds, and like I said, it's crazy matte, and that liquid suede stays on forever. So I want it to be a little glossy, and I want my lips to look a little sexy and pouty. So I'm gonna put some right in the middle. Normally I would go around it one more time with some liner, but since I forgot to bring my red, but I just wanted to do a pretty classic look for you. All right, and my lashes should be ready to apply. So I am just gonna use my fingers. Get that as close to your lash line as you can. Nice. All right. Hey, I think I did that without any problems. All right, we're gonna let that dry. And of course, the glue is white, but it'll dry clear when we are done. And I always keep these so that way whenever I clean my lashes off, I can put them right back on. And to finish it off, I am gonna use some Bare Minerals Well Rested. And I'm just going to use their Max Coverage Concealer Brush. It's really nice and big and flat. And I am going to get a little bit of that on there, and then we just tap it off. And it makes a really big difference. I really like this. It's such a cheap product. And it makes you look really nice. Look at that. See how awake it makes you look? It really helps with those pesky bags. So pretty. Okay. And here is the finished look. And I am just going for a little bit of a wave here. I don't want curly, I don't want straight. I just want kind of a very sultry, very sexy kind of a bed look. Achieved. All right, guys. I hope you have a wonderful Valentine's Day. I hope this was helpful. As always, tweak it, alter it. And I hope you guys like it. Comment, like, share, subscribe, and you'll get notified anytime I put up a video. And thank you very much for watching. You guys have a wonderful night. Bye.